for me, I did go ahead and I went with the early stoppage by three rounds, which was, I don't know. It just seemed right. You know what I'm saying? But as far as the fight itself, man, you know, I say all the time about the version of Wilder that we got in that second fight. I just think the chances of us getting that Wilder again, you know what I'm saying, slim none. You know what I'm saying? I think more so than if people could talk about Fury's strategy and all that stuff that he did and Sugar Hill this, Sugar Hill that, I feel like the biggest catalyst to how that fight played out was the condition that Wilder was in. Regardless of why people feel like he was in the condition he was in, I don't feel like it was no that happened after the knockdown. I think, you know what I'm saying, even the fact that, you know what I'm saying, he went down like he went down was even a, you know what I'm saying, it was a kind of a flukish knockdown in of itself that he turned his head as the punch was landing. But even without that, you know, the guy just didn't seem to have his bearings about him or his legs or whatever when the fight started. But, you know, that is what it is. At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, you can only fight the guy that gets in the ring in front of you. I just don't think that we're going to see that version of Wilder come Saturday night. And I think the fact that, you know, everything that's going on and all the adversity and everything is only going to make it that much more focused. So I expect him to go in there humbled because he did take a loss regardless of how it went down. But I feel like, you know what I'm saying, he's going in there. I think he really going to go in there and walk it like he's talking. You know, going there with his on a mission mentality. To go in there and get the job done, ain't in there trying to get no overtime. You know, going there and working on his jab, you know what I'm saying? Hook off the jab, throw punches to the body, and you know what I'm saying, keep his guard up, and you know what I'm saying, think he's gonna be the aggressor in there. But at the same time, be cautious and learn from the mistakes that, you know, went down in the second fight and some in the first fight. But ultimately, man, I think Wilder gonna be too much for him. And I don't care if Tyson Fury is ready or not ready or didn't have a long camp or whatever. I don't really care. He been knowing about this fight as long as we have. So, you know, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? However it plays out is how it's going to play out. The best man is going to get it done.